Hard was the word men used when they spoke of Stannis. His mouth would have given despair to even the drollest of fools. It was a mouth made for frowns and scowls and sharply worded commands, all thin pale lips and clenched muscles, a mouth that had forgotten how to smile and had never known how to laugh. Sometimes, when the world grew very still and silent of a night, Maester Cresson fancied he could hear Lord Stannis grinding his teeth half a castle away. What has Renly ever done to earn a throne? He sits in council and jests with Littlefinger, and at tourneys he dons his splendid suit of armor and allows himself to be knocked off his horse by a better man. That is the sum of my brother Renly, who thinks he ought to be a king. I ask you, why did the gods inflict me with brothers?
I cannot answer for the gods.
Yes, seldom answer at all these days, it seems to me. Who maesters for Renly? Eh, perchance I should send for him. I might like his counsel better. What do you think this maester said when my brother decided to steal my crown? What counsel did your colleague offer to this traitor blood of mine?
It would surprise me if Lord Renly sought counsel, Your Grace.
Your Grace, Stannis repeated bitterly. You mock me with a king's style. Yet what am I king of? Dragonstone and a few rocks in the narrow sea, there is my kingdom. Tonight, I am to sup with my lord's bannermen, such as they are. That Lycian pirate, Salador San, will be there with the latest tally of what I owe him. And Morrish, the merman, will caution me with talk of tides and autumn gales, while Lord Sunglass mutters piously of the will of the seven. Celtigar will want to know which storm lords are joining us. Valerian will threaten to take his levies home unless we strike at once. What am I to tell them? Why should I avenge Eddard Stark? The man was nothing to me. Oh, Robert loved him, to be sure. Loved him as a brother. Often did I hear that. I was his brother, not Ned Stark. But you would never have known it by the way he treated me. I held Storm's End for him, watching good men starve, while Mace Tyrell and Paxter Redwine feasted within sight of my walls. Did Robert thank me? No. He thanked Stark for lifting the siege when we were down to rats and radishes. I built a fleet at Robert's command, took Dragonstone in his name. Did he take my hand and say, "Well done, brother, whatever should I do without you?" No. He blamed me. I sat in his council for 15 years, helping John Arryn rule his realm while Robert drank and awed. And when John died, did my brother name me his hand? No, he went galloping off to his dear friend Ned Stark and offered him the honor. Your God can keep his grace. It's swords I need, not blessings. Do you have an army hidden somewhere that you've not told me of?